Please get ready for transcription number 491 and 492. 5 seconds. Start. Sir, I know for some time past how this government is functioning. Take, for instance, the Commerce and Industry Ministry. Since the last one decade, this ministry has faced many changes. It has changed, reorganized many things, sometimes inflated and sometimes deflated, to suit the particular individuals who occupy the place of power. In the beginning, as the House is aware, there was the Commerce and Industry Ministry. It had within its fold external and internal trade, many of the public undertakings, private sector companies and small industries too. But from time to time, as I said, this ministry has been cut and changed and suffered because of a particular person in power. So the ministry became weak and small as time went on. The net result was that no effective functioning was possible. It is amazing how a vital ministry, the Ministry of Commerce and Industry, has been subject to such vicissitudes, has been subject to such changes. We all know that no ministry can function in an atmosphere of instability and uncertainty. There has got to be some continuity, otherwise the ministry cannot develop its own character, its own personality. But unfortunately, there is a continuous disintegration of the Commerce and Industry Ministry. And what is the picture today? Today, sir, the different limbs of this ministry have been scattered among various ministries and departments. The net result is that if you go to the secretariat, you will have to a perfect picture of confusion. We members of parliament are at a loss to know what is what in this ministry. We are amazed that even the officers functioning in the various sectors have no sense of responsibility because they themselves do not know their powers and responsibilities. The picture is very confusing. As a consequence of this confusion, which is increasing, the work has suffered, efficiency has suffered, and the importance of the ministry has considerably gone down. It has lost character and personality. We talk of industrialization of the country. We talk of rapid economic development. Unless the ministry is clear-headed or properly organized, it would be difficult to bring about rapid economic transformation or quick economic development. So my first remark is that the Ministry of Commerce and Industry has to be properly reorganized so that there can be effective functioning, there may be far better coordination, and there may be fruitful work. Take, for instance, the huge number of complaints about licensing. We do not know what is the policy of licensing. In certain sectors, there has been over-licensing. In certain others, there is not much of licensing. Also, we see that the licenses which have been granted have not been properly utilized, partly because the government has not been able to remove some of the official bottlenecks. Take the instance of collaboration agreements. In the matter of collaboration, we find considerable delay and lack of quick decision. As a result, the licenses issued by the department have not been utilized. Again, take the import and export wing of the department, and there you may see the same slackness, the same indecision, and the same indefiniteness about anything. Therefore, for the ministry to function effectively, it is necessary that the ministry should have a stable future and should have adequate powers and responsibilities. No modern country in the world can cut or slash portfolios or ministries without rational basis, but unfortunately, here and particularly in this ministry, slashing or cutting has been going on without heed being paid to the needs of development and to the needs of efficiency. I'm afraid if this process were to continue, it would be difficult to create the climate and confidence which are so necessary for running industries in this country. My friend was speaking about state trading. On this question, I feel that no precise policy decision has been made by the government so far. I say this because any policy decision should be preceded by a lot of thinking, and it has to be done preferably at the budget time or before that. Now a decision has been taken by the government that instead of one state trading corporation, there should be two. The reason given is that there is enormous increase in the work and range of activity, and therefore another corporation is necessary, and there should be more allotment of grant for that purpose. I should like to know what are the important sectors of trade which will come under state trading in the future, and if there had been planning or a policy, certainly there should be perspective for the next 10 or 15 years as to how state trading will develop. But by looking at the history of state trading, I feel that no attempt has been made to systematize the work, and no planning is there, and the country does not know what would be the extent of state trading and what would be the schedule of commodities which the state trading is now going to take up. Sir, I should like to deal with some of the recommendations of the committee, particularly their observations in regard to closer coordination between the central government and the state governments. The question of making health a central subject was discussed in the country's Constituent Assembly, and the members did not accept the suggestion made at that time that health should be made a central subject. It is primarily a state subject, but it is also in the concurrent list. But sir, we feel that this was reflected this morning in the answers to the Minister of Health to a short notice question on cholera in Orissa, that there is not sufficient coordination between the central government and the state governments. Cholera has broken out in Orissa. The Orissa government has not asked for the help of the central government, and the central government on its own initiative has not offered any help to the Orissa government. Stop.